Today, we are going to learn about automatic map interpretation using map to model in the Phenix GUI. The purpose of Phenix map to model is to take a three-dimensional map like this one and interpret it to produce an atomic model. Let's see how map to model works. First, the input map is optimized for clarity. This is done using the Phenix auto sharpen tool. Next, the unique part of the map is identified to avoid duplication of effort. Then, models are built into the unique part of the map using several independent methods. Finally, the best parts of all the models are assembled into a final model. Here, the green is the known structure of a ribosome, and the brown is the structure built by map to model. Note that map to model produces a preliminary model, not a fully complete one. The key input for map interpretation is the map file. It can be in any standard format, such as MRC or CCP format or MTZ format. The map can come from cryo-EM or from crystallography. It is not necessary to sharpen the map beforehand, as this will be done by map to model. The high resolution limit of the map will also be needed. The resolution limit is used to reduce the contribution of high resolution noise to the map. For a cryo-EM map, you can use the resolution limit you have identified using half dataset Fourier shell correlations. For an X-ray map, you can use the resolution of your data. A sequence file is also needed. This tells map to model what is in the map and whether it is protein, RNA, or DNA, or a combination of these. If symmetry has been applied during reconstruction of the map, a symmetry file is helpful. You can also specify the symmetry type, such as D7 or I. Now let's automatically interpret a map for part of a rotavirus structure from the Phenix tutorials. Here is the map that we are going to interpret. It is a pretty clear map, but as we will see, it needs sharpening. In the main Phenix GUI, click on New Project and then Setup Tutorial Data. In the pull-down menu under cryo-EM, select the Model Building Tutorial. Choose a suitable place to put the files and hit OK. Now there will be a new rotavirus project listed for you. It contains a small part of a rotavirus map cut out with the Phenix Mapbox tool. We are going to build into this small map. Let's run Map to Model. Under Model Building, select Map to Model. Let's enter a title. Let's find the map in the tutorial directory. Pick rotavirus short box.ccp4. If there were reconstruction symmetry used, we could enter it here under NCS file. NCS is the term in crystallography corresponding to reconstruction symmetry. We need a sequence file. Let's get it from the tutorial directory. Let's set the resolution to 2.6 angstroms and the number of processors to 4. We're ready to go. Hit run. And as map to model starts, a new map to model run will appear. The run status tab will show the log file. Map to model can take a while to run. For a ribosome, it may be many days unless you use many processors. This tutorial data takes about an hour to run. The first thing that map to model does is automatically sharpen the map. Here, it is automatically identifying the optimal sharpening by maximizing the clarity and connectivity of the map, combined to yield adjusted surface area, or SA. The optimal sharpening is a B-sharpen of 35 angstrom squared, leading to a maximal SA of 4. Here's the original map we saw before, and the sharpened map, which looks much clearer. Next, map-to-model chooses the region to build in, builds several models, puts everything together, refines it, and writes out map-to-model.pdb. Here is the end of the log file. Map-to-model has built 152 residues in 13 chains.
The map-model correlation is 0.78, which is very good, and the final model has been copied to map-to-model.pdb.
In the Results tab, let's click Open in Qt, and we can see the sharpened map and the model that has been built. This is the kind of result that you would expect for a high-resolution map. At lower resolution, the model will be less complete, and the sequence may not be matched to the model. The next step will be manual model building to fill out the model
and refinement to optimize the model. Good luck with using map to model on your map. If you have questions or feedback, you are welcome to contact us at help@phoenixonline.org or tutorials@phoenixonline.org.